My food philosophy has always been to showcase the best of the Philippines side by side with the best of the world. So most of the dishes that I put together, most especially when they're meant for a foreign audience, is really to do that, to showcase how our Filipino ingredients can stand their own beside, I mean, the best that the world has to offer. Islas Pinas is a heritage Filipino food hall that actually fell on my lap quite accidentally. It was a project of Double Dragon that they started last year, and they actually brought it to the attention of then Undersecretary Berna Puyat, and they asked her for help to find out how, you know, they could mobilize and get a team together to help them do the food for the venue. It's a beautiful space. You have a replica of the Balanghay, the boat, that's right in the middle where you can actually sit and eat. Of course, there's the iconic Nipa Hut in the middle, you know, that can house maybe 20 people for lunch or dinner. And at the same time, I think the most novel part is the area that they call Tusuk Tusuk, which is like the urban part of the space where we do street food. And at the same time, there's like a replica of an overpass. And, you know, there's also a man selling balut, which is really what the experience that you get as you walk through the streets of Manila. And when Secretary Berna spoke to me about it, I guess she knew how I felt strongly about pushing for Filipino cuisine. It's always been my dream to do the Filipino version of Italy, which is like this huge space showcasing the best produce, the best artisanal products, and at the same time have different restaurant spaces where you can do different concepts. It's still a work in progress, and I'd like to think that I just went full circle. You know, I always say that maybe I must have been Italian in my past life, and I'm thinking, why Italian food, right? But I think that it's been an absolute gift, because then Italian cuisine is all about home cooking. The heart and soul of it is really your mother's cooking, and it's also a lot about respect for ingredients. Like I said, it's like the biggest lesson that I learned. And I think that awareness, I took that back coming home, and that's actually what made me fall in love with our own cuisine and our own ingredients all over again. Although the appreciation went by way of Italy, I think that it made it so much easier for me to really advocate more strongly for what's our own.